all come together to fight the violations of human rights, injustice, oppression, and corruption by the government and even non-governmental groups against the everyday people. We must remove the cause of the problem and secure the rights of the people from being violated. Let us face the truth to help change the outcome in the end. We can all stand together or wait to go down one day. The choice is simply ours. One love.
One heart, let's get together and feel all right. Hear the children crying.
This is one of the victims of Godswill Akpabio victimization, brutality, and terrorism. You know, say something about what happened.
A lot of our people is still in Ikot Ekpene. They are not seeing a way to come back home. So unfortunately, I thank God I am here in New York. I don't have anything to say.
Well, you heard that as a citizen.
This is one of these wounded victims of political election attack by the PDP thugs. This is the wound they gave to him. Damaged his leg, paralyzed him. He's sitting on a POP and with the crutches right now as a result of political attack.
So I have this wound during the incident at Ikot Ekpene.
Okay. Were you matched by the PDP people or you were wounded by the PDP thugs?
The thugs.
Okay, of the PDP at Ikot Ekpene. Okay, they were the people that sustained damaged your leg in this form, right? Okay, this thing happened on a Tuesday, 22nd, 10, right? On that campaign day. Okay, at Ikot Ekpene. Okay, you actually sustained this injury at Ikot Ekpene. Okay, thank you very much.
He started inflicting wounds of machete. He gone, wounds everything on me. They have matched these 2 points, the back and here. The whole of my back, they were using wounds on me. I cannot even raise my hand up.
Please turn around a little bit. Let me. Okay. Let me. Okay. This is the wound inflicted. This man that was doing his civic duty. A wound to call beauty. But these are the things that the thugs of PDP, the late government of Godswill Akpabio. This is all we got. I don't know how free and fair this kind of election would be when there's such anger and this injustice on a law-abiding citizen.
Somebody told me at my back, at least. When I told my back, I started fucking beating me, stealing everything. The other one used to knock my head, the one used a devil head, a devil leg. All my head, all over my body.
Have you made any smart report to the police?
He went, when there was no attention, didn't give any attention.
Well, we're sorry for what has happened. We do hope that, you know, something will be done. Let me film that. Thank you, please. Okay. All right.
I interviewed him the other day, no?
What happened?
You know that those Godswill Akpabio boys, those boys came in from the bush with the machete and a gun. They start to beat us. They use a machete on
Did you go there for a war with them?
No, we did not. We went to campaign. We went to Udoedehe campaign because we know that Udoedehe can even come and Udoedehe will come and change the government. That's why I like to follow government. We don't want the boss in a vibe. Those people start getting with us.
All right. This is one of the people yesterday that Godswill Akpabio, the so-called governor of the state of Akwa Ibom, terrorized the people, sent gang and killers to injure and kill our people, the citizen that is supposed to protect. This is what he has done to them. His people, there are thousands of people just like this that, but we've not been able to get access to some of them because it's been very hectic since that yesterday. But this individual has been treated and released. He's right here, right now, you know, from this chaos and a tyrannic government of Godswill Akpabio. So, can you say something?
There's nothing I can say to say that Godswill Akpabio should not do anything in this state. My governor, John Udoedehe, should do something. That's my word.
Okay, all right, thank you.
About the campaign rally that we go in Ikot Ekpene local government. We did not go to problem, but when we get there, we have a group attacking us from PDP people. So when I get down to the vehicle, they shoot.
Okay, the bullets.
Yeah.
That gives you the wound.
Yes. So this is the wound when they shoot me from the bullets.
My younger brother is here in Unio, yeah.
Okay.
He's also a member of SN and he's living with me. We went for campaign yesterday at Ikot Ekpene.
Okay.
So when arriving in Ikot Ekpene, we saw a lot of problems. They're shooting guns from the PDP members from Ikot Ekpene there. So a lot of us, even the motor I was in there, so we were trying to divert back to go back to Uyo for the sake of the incident that happens there. So my younger brother drive with on my bike. He was on my own bike driving. So after the incident that might have happened, we now run back to Uyo here. So even up till these hours of time, I have not seen my younger brother. His phone number has not been going through. I've tried to call him since last night, even up to now. He hasn't been going through and he has not been yet back. So that's the problem I'm having. So I came here to report since morning. I've reported for over 4 people telling them that about my brother incident. Even though they say I should wait, that he will be back. Up to now, he has not yet returned. I've not seen him. I've not heard anything about him up to this hour's time. That's the problem I'm having.
So you fear that probably Akpabio people might have...
I thought maybe the people from Akpabio, the people that Akpabio sent to attack us from Ikot Ekpene, maybe they might have killed him. That's my problem.
We're very sorry about it, everything, but we're trying to make sure that we can try to at least locate most bodies that are, you know, probably most people that have died. But since they have done that in their territory, they probably, most dead bodies have been hidden by these people. But we pray that nothing has happened to your brother. Just have a little bit of patience. Let's see what happened. You know what I'm saying? Okay?
Okay.
All right. This is another vehicle, as you can see, destroyed by the agents of Godswill
Akpabio.
This is one of the victims, the citizen of this state, a fiber state. As a matter of fact, this car is his car and also went through the destruction and the attack caused by Godswill Akpabio and the gangs and thugs.
My vehicle was used on the rescue operation. I was using the vehicle as an ambulance, since we could not lay hand on any ambulance available. So I was picking the victims. But fortunately for me, when I was at Ikot Ekpene, I came trying to rescue some people from being attacked. When I came, they blocked the route. They started using machetes, axe, hammer, and stones to break all the windscreen, both front and back, the side, the travicator, and every other thing. They even ordered us. I forced myself when they blocked the route and climbed what they used in blocking the route. Then escaped. If not, 5 of us were inside the vehicle.
Also, another vehicle that was destroyed, killed by the gang of Godswill Akpabio, the so-called governor of Akwaibu State, who's been attacking the masses, sending his thugs to kill men, people, destroy properties. And so, this is what just a few, very few of
a lot of properties destroyed by Godswill Akpabio's agents and thugs, just to make sure that nobody else can come into the race for governorship. These are some of the destroyed vehicles by the agents of Godswill Akpabio who attacked us yesterday at Ikot Ekpene, his place where he comes from, that he barred us from getting in to do our campaign. So all this, just few among so many cars that he has destroyed. The people open that. This is all car destroyed.
The brake front and back.
Because it's been protected now, so the rain falls, it will not get in. All this. This is the destruction caused by Godswill Akpabio. This is all the broken glasses that injured a lot of people. And then, all the way there, he sent people to attack the masses in the street of Ikot Ekpene. And then this is another vehicle that was destroyed. This is a few that we were able to manage to still move it to bring it back. So many of other cars have been burned in the street. This is the destruction of Godswill Akpabio's people. Also this one, these are all the destruction. Cars have been destroyed by the people. And these are the cars. Very few of the cars. man blood after, you know, the agents of Godswill Akpabio attacked the masses. Those are blood in there, blood of innocent civilians, innocent masses. And Godswill Akpabio sent his people to kill, to maim, and to destroy all this cause, and cause this injuries and death to people in front of this car, you know, so this is the handiwork of Godswill Akpabio and his gang attacking the citizens of Akwa Ibom. Just to materialize his wish of coming back for a second term. These are bullet holes. These are bullet holes. Of course, this is a destruction.
Insecurity in Akwa Ibom State. It shows the desperation of the governor and the PDP in the state. It is very instructive and indeed very disgraceful that this ugly incident happened at the doorstep of the governor. In his hometown and a few minutes drive from his country home.
See them fighting for power.
Akpabio era operated as one of government parastata in Akwa Ibom. As I am talking to you, Governor Akpabio is boasting that he has paid 500 million naira to the police authority in Abuja to ensure that Mr. Magaji, who refused to tag along with him, was transferred and has gotten somebody who will cooperate with him in his bid to rig the forthcoming elections in the state. We urge the federal government to rein in Oduma, the Joint Military Task Force in the state, because they too have been corrupted by Governor Akpabio. Today, even though the whole state knows the truth about what happened yesterday, our supporters are being arrested, and Governor Akpabio has ordered that our leaders be arrested and detained until the elections are over. As law-abiding citizens,